Hey, AJ Gergich here, and today I'm going to talk to you about what a content gap is in the sense of SEO and how to use tools to fill those content gaps much easier than we ever used to be able to do in the past. So a content gap is exactly what it sounds like. A content gap means your competitors have content that you don't. There's literally a gap there, and not just content that you lack, but content that they're ranking for that you would like to rank for. And so sometimes when you're, you know, beating your head against the wall, why am I not ranking for this keyword? A lot of times if you really look, you know, you may not have the best asset on your site to actually rank for that keyword. So today, because it's fun and exciting, I thought we would look at a live example and show you a tool that I use to make this process much easier. So I figured it would be super exciting if we were to check out tire companies, right? Because, yeah. So that's what we're going to do. I'm here on Goodyear's website. That's the tires I have on my car right now. So I started with them. And we're going to look at how they compare and what content gaps they have against some of their competitors. So the tool that I use for this is hrefs.com. It is a paid tool, but they do have, I think, about a 14-day free trial. I'll double check on that, but I'm pretty sure that it is. So you can get this and use this for free if you just want to try it out and see if this is for you. They have lots and lots of options. They're, you know, kind of an industry standard SEO tool. But for today, we're just going to talk about this right here, content gaps. They've come out with this feature, and it's made it so much more easy to identify where these gaps exist with you and your competitors. So let's do this for Goodyear and see how they stack up. So when you click content gaps, it's going to pre-fill this right here. And what it's going to ask you for is to put in domain names of your competitors. And this is pre-checked. You probably want to leave it checked so that at least one of these targets that you put in rank in the top 10. What's cool is you can also add in additional if you want. Now, I've already filled this out. So I've put in Firestone, Cooper Tire, and Michelin. And then, you know, you hit show keywords and it shows you a lot of keywords. So this is around 8,000 keywords that are showing up where one of these competitors, in this case, a lot of them seem to be Michelin, are ranking, but Goodyear is not. So this is an excellent way to find these content gaps. Now, what you'll find is when you're looking at large brands, the branded terms tend to carry a lot of weight. So what I would do here is maybe say, okay, let's look from 100 to 4,000 search volume, and that is monthly searches. So when you're doing that, it's not daily or anything like that. So that'll update. And let's see what we got. We got 1600. It's still a lot. Let's go three words and up just to get some of those shorter phrases out of there. And then we're left with still 1200. So you could keep playing around with filtering. I will say, I wish that they had a way for me to enter in a search right here or negative keywords. That would be nice. So if I could take out branded terms like Cooper, I'm actually going to shoot them an email. They're very responsive. They may have that on their roadmap already, or maybe they'll implement it once recommended. They have a very responsive team to suggestions. So since I can't do that, since I can't easily, you know, get rid of Michelin and these things to get to what I want to see, I would go ahead and just hit export. So you hit export, which I've already done, and you get an Excel doc. So in the interest of, so you can see the data without having to sign up and things like that, I actually created this, copied and pasted over to a Google Doc. This Google Doc will be linked down in the description, so you will be able to access it. It'll be locked down, but you can access it and just go file, make a copy if you want to play around with the data. So here you see I've exported, I think I just exported 1,000, so it cut off at a little bit. There was more data, but this will be plenty for our purposes. So let's take a look at what I would do. Here, I'm not looking for branded terms that if I'm Goodyear that I'm missing out on. So I would do things like this. How? Okay, there's 12 questions. How to check tire pressure? I mean, no brainer, right? That's something that if I'm Goodyear, I would want to rank for. Well, they don't. And what's interesting is really none of their competitors do except for Michelin, which ranks number 4. So if you keep going down this, you'll see this. How often do you replace tires? Nobody's ranking but Michelin. Over and over and over, I'm seeing this. And so these are content gaps. These are gaps where one competitor is ranking and the rest are not. And so if I was, you know, doing SEO here or content marketing, this would be one of the first things to address is make a large document dump of all the assets you have, all the assets you don't have, all the content gaps you need to fill. And, you know, this is ideation right here. This is data driven. We lack this content. It doesn't rank. Either we need to revise it, the existing content we have, or create new content. So you can see just pretty much anywhere you go, you know, need new tires. That sounds pretty transactional, right? Like that, I would want that if I was Goodyear. They don't rank. And again, it's Michelin that ranks and they're number 3. So honestly, I'm pretty curious because, you know, Goodyear is a big brand. And so I go over to Google and I put in a site command. If you're not familiar with this, this just tells Google only search Goodyear.com. So you cite Goodyear.com with the colon. And then I've told it, not only are we doing that, I want the phrase need new tires in quotes so that's kind of exactly appearing. So Goodyear actually does have this. It appears on the site, the phrase, but it's probably not quality content or else it would rank, right? And so when you click in, look at that. That's the worst user experience right there. So this is what they're putting out and that's why they're not ranking, right? Now, this is probably some kind of print page or something that's getting mixed up and probably really even shouldn't be indexed in this way. But again, it's a problem. That you can easily use a tool like Ahrefs and identify these content gaps and then go about filling them. It's a simple SEO technique that everyone can use. And hopefully, leave a message down in the comments if you find that helpful, or if you have any specific questions about it further, I'll definitely answer in the comments. But I just wanted to give you something simple and actionable that you could try out right now to have better SEO on your site.